Okay, so today we're going to solve the absolute value inequality, and we're going to express the answer using interval notation. So let's get started by the first example. So we have x minus 3. The absolute value of x minus 3 less or equal than 1. Okay, so when you have this kind of equation, absolute value of something less or equal than 1, that means your x minus 3 is going to be between negative 1 and 1. So x minus 3 is between negative 1 and 1. So that means x minus 3 is greater than or equal than negative 1, and x minus 3 is less than or equal than 1. Okay, so let's start by solving this first inequality. So x minus 3 greater than or equal than negative 1. So we're going to move the negative 3 to the other side. So that gives us x greater than or equal than 2. And we have x minus 3, so we move the negative 3 to the other side, so we have x less than or equal than 4. So let's do our line. So we have, since this is greater than or equal, less than or equal, that means we're gonna close in 2 and 4. So let's choose another color here. So x greater than or equal than 2, that means what? So that means from 2 to infinity. And we have x less than or equal than 4. That means from negative infinity to 4. So the solution is the intersection, because we have the end. So our solution is going to be 2, 4. Let's go now to the second example. So we have the absolute value of x plus 1 greater than or equal than 1. So how to solve this kind of equation when we have the greater than or equal? So this is when you have this sign of inequality greater than or equal, that means x plus 1 is going to be outside the interval negative 1 and 1. So that means your x plus 1 is less than or equal than negative 1, or x plus 1 greater than or equal than 1. Okay, so, and don't forget this is or. Okay, so let's solve the x plus 1 less or equal than negative 1. So we're going to move the 1 to the other side. This gives us negative 1 and negative 1. So it's negative 2, and x, and we move the 1 to the other side, that gives us 1 minus 1, this is 0. So we have x less than or equal than negative 2, or x greater than or equal than 0. So let's do our line and choose another color. So we have negative 2 close, because we have less than or equal than 2 and greater than or equal than 0. So it's going to be close than negative 2 and 0. So x less than or equal than negative 2, that means from negative infinity to negative 2. X greater than or equal than 0, that means from 0 to positive infinity. So the solution of this inequality is negative infinity to negative 2. We close the brackets and union 0 to infinity. So the last example is this. So we have 8 minus the absolute value of 2x plus 9 less or equal than 3. So how to solve this kind of equation? So first of all, we're going to isolate the absolute value. So how do isolate the absolute value? So you're going to move the 8 to the other side. So we just subtract the 8 both sides. So we do, let's choose another card. So we're going to do negative 8 from here, negative 8 from here. So the 8 and negative 8 is going to be canceled out. So I'm going to drop the negative 2x plus 9, drop down this inequality less than or equal. So 3 minus 8, it gives us negative 5. And then since we have a negative here in front of the absolute values, I'm going to just multiply both sides by negative 1. Okay, when I multiply both sides by negative 1, so I have to switch the sign of the inequality, which is going to be greater than or equal. Don't forget this. So when you multiply by a negative, so you just switch the sign. So this is going to be 2x plus 9, absolute value of 2x plus 9, greater than or equal to positive 5. So this is an absolute value with the greater than or equal a sign. So this is we're gonna use the property of the second example. So this is 2x plus 9 less than or equal than negative 5, or 2x plus 9 greater than or equal than 5. So we're gonna just solve the first equation and the second equation. Okay, so we're gonna move the negative 9 to the other side. Let me do this. So negative 9 both sides. So the negative 9 is gonna be canceled out. So I left with 2x less than or equal than negative 14. So I'm gonna divide both sides by 2. So it's gonna be negative 14 by 2. And it gives me x less than or equal. Let me just clear this. So it gives me x less than or equal than negative 7. So this is a negative 14. So this is the first solution for the first equation. And for the second equation, we're gonna move the 9 to the other side. So I'm gonna add negative 9 both sides. So 9 is gonna be canceled out. So I left with 2x greater than or equal than negative 4. And then I'm gonna divide it both sides by 2. So x is gonna be greater than or equal to negative 2. So this is a two solution, and we have an or here. Okay, so now let me do a line. So I'm gonna just clear this here. Okay, so if I do a line, so we have x, so it's close on negative 7, and negative 7 is less than negative 2 because of the negative sign. So we have x less than or equal than negative 7. What does it mean? That means it's from negative infinity to negative 7. And we have or x greater than or equal than negative 2. That means from negative 2 to positive infinity. Since I have the or, that means the union. So the solution is going to be negative infinity to negative 7, close, union negative 2, infinity. And this is the solution.